Oh, sorry about that. I had my air conditioning blasting. Oh my gosh, I'm here, I can't believe it. This is astonishing. Let's see, turn that over there. Okay, I don't want anything. Well, hello everybody. I had a bunch of running around the house, so I'm probably out of breath. I haven't gotten any blue juice. I've been up and down and up and down the stairs trying to get the router to work. And I hope you're watching this show and not the whole prelude music thing that I put up there. Anyway, yeah, we should be working now. Oh yeah, yay. Let's see, I got sounds, they're off right now. I've got all kinds of stuff going on for us to fool around with. So, without further ado, let's switch over to the comment stream here, and let's see, there we are. Oops, no, that's not the comment stream. You madman. Oh, I forgot, I have to change some settings. Da-da-da. Duplicate these displays. Apply. Uh-oh, wait. Oh, I did the same mistake last week. Wait a minute. First, I have to stop the neat special effects from going on in the background, right? Revert. There we go. Okay. So, special effects. And, can't even find where I am now. Okay, there we go. There. Okay, I got him to stop. All right. So I can turn that off. And I can turn that off. Okay, be right with you. And duplicate these displays. And apply. Okay. Sheesh. Ay-yi-yi. I tell you, difficult knowing what planet you're on sometimes. Okay, let's see if I can get the other pages up here. I got here we go, I got that, I have this, and I have this. Ay-yi-yi. Okay, I did it. Ta-da! So we have the show working. Golly. You would not believe what was going on. I mean, I started OBS and it started streaming this stuff and it shows me it going into yellow and then to red and then the little dropped frames indicator just starts counting up all these thousands of frames that it's dropping because it just wouldn't connect. And I don't know why. So I went downstairs and what finally seemed to solve it, well, I restarted the router, but I also changed the little splitter box that goes to the TV this way and to the router that way. I changed it out for the new one they'd given me. So it might have just been that's all it was because all of a sudden now it's working or else who knows? I don't know what. But anyway, good old Time Warner finally gave me my internet back. So, all right, thank goodness. Okay, yay. I tell you. Sometimes I wonder why I put myself through this. No, I know exactly why I put myself through this. It's a blast. Okay, let's do some. I didn't get a chance to do any sound tests or anything, so let me quickly do some sound checks and stuff like that, because I have to see if my various sound works. You know, if I even have music working over here. All right, let's see. The heck? Ah, there it is. All right. And this can go down. And this can go down. I'm sorry that all this nonsense, but I just have to. Okay, so let's try a quick performance with reverb setup. Okay. And start that up. Oh, I wonder it didn't work. That's a weird sound. Ugh. Okay, no, that's not the musical interlude. Let's test the other one, because I didn't get a chance to test any of these configs. And we've got just keyboards. Oh, this one. This is a different sound. Okay, let's see. Oh. I know the one I want. Oh, I thought I knew the one I wanted. Well, I really should get up the thing I was going to use. What the heck? Okay, finally things are sort of ready. And let me, oh, one more thing. Finally, golly. All right. So, all right, now I'm kind of ready. All right, sheesh. All right, don't worry, it's going to get better, but I just had to have some crisis because, you know, otherwise it wouldn't have been enough crisis for tonight. Okay, so let's get on with what the show's going to be about. Actually, I have a pretty good show planned. Mm-hmm. For one thing, oh, let's start at the bottom and move up. Okay, so I had some share posts of the week. I was a guest on a couple of shows, I was guest on a couple of programs, and let's just make this big, and I have to change something. One second. Doo-doo-doo. This is something I always have to do. Here we go. Okay. I was guest on a couple of shows. We talked about mobile, the mobile explosion, mobile get-in. And also, I was guest with Scott Scowcroft, with Elaine Nader-Beating and Kristen Drysdale. On the subject of variety, and they invited me on because I do a variety show, okay, with a whole variety of crises that happen during the show, and that's why I kind of like do all these jujitsu movements and dances and all this kind of stuff to deflect attention from the fact that everything's going crazy and nothing's organized at all, but otherwise I have it together. So So we'll talk about that. I'll share the links in the show notes. You'll see the archives are all in yellow this week because I'm going to do a little archives review this week and talk about some of the stuff we've done in past weeks. Mm-hmm. So that would be fun. That'll be fun, and a bunch of other stuff will be fun. Let's see. It'll be fun to have me be less green. I feel green. I know it's because of all the running around I did trying to fix that router. Well, let me just make myself less green, okay? I'll feel better. There we go. I'd rather be purple than green any day. I don't know. Is that too purple? I don't know. I have no idea. You tell me if I just ruined it. Okay, so we're going to have some archives reviews this week. All we have to discuss in some of these bottom ones are the archives things. But we also have a Google's Amazing Tools this week we're going to talk about. Picasa. Okay? And Picasa is more than just a place to kind of put your pictures. It's a very, actually now, pretty advanced digital asset management system for your photos, in that you can really label your photos and categorize them using standards, IPTC standard methodology, as well as using custom tags. But the fact that you can use the standards as well means that it will work in more expensive digital asset management programs. So it's no slouch of a program. It's a pretty darn good thing. So we're going to look at that. And let's see, we have some free background music of the week, which is ambient ambulance, and the sound effect of the week is coffee shop. Yeah, I feel like playing that one right now, you know? So I have a little background music here. And so let's see if I can find, go to my favorites. I did favorite it, pretty sure. I hope I did. Oh, lo and behold, I didn't favorite it. Okay, so let's go find it. Hey, we'll talk about something right away. Okay, so we got sound effects, and we have the category was ambiences. Okay, and in fact, that's really what I want to talk about, ambiences, because ambiences is one of the cooler categories. And here we have coffee shops, so I'll go ahead and play that, and hopefully you can hear it. And let's see. Oh, you can't hear it because I have that turned down. So I'll have to bring it up 1 second. There we go. All right. There it is. I hear it. It's very quiet. It's ambience. It's just to kind of give you guys a feeling like I'm not just sitting, you know, somewhere in a house in Elizabeth City, that I'm actually in someplace cool. Right outside the door is like cool people talking and laughing and stuff. So anyways, that's coffee shop. It's the sound effect of the week. The thing is, under the category of ambiences are a whole bunch of really good ones, and they tend to be long as well. Where you have some longer ones. Now, we did play some in the past, and some were really, really strange. Factory Morning Startup, we tried a few weeks ago. It was like, you know, I should preview these things a little more carefully, you know. It starts out just like an actual Factory Morning starts out, with nobody there. And so it's like 4 minutes of silence. Before people finally start showing up. Anyway, but this is a coffee shop, and you have some others. You have, you know, like convention hall, ambience, and stuff like that. So anyway, I'm not sure you're hearing much, but it doesn't sound like much. I thought there'd be a lot more going on in this convention. Not much to me. Oh, how about let's get something that has some volume. It's not a lot. Let's see if I can pull up this thing and crank it up a little bit. It doesn't seem to be doing much for me. Anyway, okay, well, I hope the rest of the sounds in the background aren't as killer as this one. I can just smell the manure. Oh, wow. Well, I live in an agricultural region, so I always do. Or cat litter, one of those things. Okay, so there you ambiences, that's the subject. Let's get back to the subject at hand that we were actually talking about. What else are we doing today? We're doing a little quick review on the Lightworks program again. I'm going to encourage people to download that thing, give it a try, look at it. We are going to look at Cam Studio with a caveat of get it at SourceForge, not at the campstudio.org website, because a lot of people have been getting burned by that installer by not declining all of the myriad endless numbers of offers that come through. So you can get a better version at the SourceForge website, where it's actually a previous version, but it lacks a bug that the new version introduced. So to me, it's better. Guided meditations, we're going to do some stories. Now, a couple of weeks ago, we had a plus word game, and everybody seemed to know this hint that was being given about a bunion or something. I don't know what the heck it was, but there people were naming the blue ox, and I'd completely forgotten about Paul Bunyan's blue ox. And so we're feature Paul Bunyan both in the story this week and in the poem, with a poem by Shel Silverstein called Paul Bunyan that he wrote many years ago. Well, 1972. And, okay, so a little bit of audio magic. We're going to talk about adding a fade in and a fade out in an Audacity thing. Not a whole lot. Making use of bad images. I've got a great example of an image to do. Going to look at the, I'm going to just mention the word Patreon, and that's it for the thing. There, I'm done. So I'm done. I mentioned the word Patreon. Everyone knows what that is. But we're going to look at the archives of the YouTube feature. Well, so that's a lot of features, too, we're going to talk about this week have to do with the archives. Okay, so we're going to do a lot of reviewing of the archives. But till then, I say it's time for a musical interlude to calm my nerves and steal my wits about me. Okay, so and here we go. Let's look at a few comments anyway. Oh yes. truly. Oh, very good. And yeah, it's like my sound just doesn't seem to be happening for the getting sounds from the system audio on that computer into my system. But we'll see. Okay. Picasso, yes. Named for Pablo Picasso, in fact. And so I'm glad Andrew makes someone feel more normal. That's good. It's a good thing. Because he just makes me feel like, I'm just not quite normal all the time sometimes. So it's not like I am, but maybe. Okay. Oh, yes. Try Pixlr. Okay, so let's go ahead to the thing, and I'll try to get the sounds working, and we'll do a little bit of keyboard, a little bit of flute. Or maybe I'll just do a flute right now. Yeah, that's what I'll do first. Woo! There we go, okay. All right. And hit save. Sometimes I'm just doing a flute. Let's go. That looks awful. Let's not do that. I should have something cool behind me if I'm going to do just flute, right? Oh, gosh. Yeah, let's do that. Let's get the old screensaver back here. Is that going to work? No. Wouldn't you know it? It's not going to work. Earlier. No. I just can't today.
Thank you.
Okie dokie. So there was that. Let's go over here to this. And, oh, Eileen had to take off, huh? Oh, my. Oh, yes. My above normal brain, because, you know, I know it's above here, so it's, I don't know. Anyway, yes. Ah, well, okay. Oh boy. Yes, you heard some flute. So we finally got some a musical interlude going on. And oh my gosh, but my stream is falling apart. It says bad. Oh no. Wouldn't you know it? Look at this. I'm going to show you what's going on here. Look at that. It says my stream is bad. And yet it's showing down here that it's okay. But I just dropped 6,568 frames. Isn't that wonderful? Well, I'm so glad that this happens to me. So it's probably something to do with that I've been a bad boy. Okay. Well, I'll tell you what. I'm going to start recording the show on the side in the background so that I can at least broadcast a new show. So we're going to make believe we're starting over here. And now it says the health is good, but I guess during the flute thing, we had some dropouts and everything breaking, and, okay, all right, there you go. So, well, I don't know, people aren't complaining, so who knows when it dropped out and got really ugly and bad, but I'll keep watching that so that I see any more bad signs. Born under a bad sign there. Okay, so what are we going to do next? Well, you know, I wanted to get this over with so long. I wanted to show this Pixlr tutorial that really, really, to me, demonstrates the whole essence of the reason why the Three Musketeers were so famous. So now that I've got your interest piqued, I will warn you that this will have nothing to do with the Three Musketeers in just a moment. However, I had to start out with that because it's such a popular thing, and I was going to read some stories about the Three Musketeers, but I didn't. However, first, I'd like to do a little bit feature on our visual sponsor, who is Electric Sheep, who creates the really neat tool that, Oh no, what's happening? What's happening to you two? What's happening to D? Oh well. Anyway, here's Electric Sheep. Electricsheep.org. And this is where the effects are generated, and you can see them over here on the right, and some example free things. And you just go into download, and it works on Mac, Linux, Windows, iPad, and Android. I have it on my Android device and on the PC, obviously. And it's really, really awesome how well it works. Okay, and your computer actually becomes part of a conglomerate of thousands and thousands of computers that are working together to create these images. So the result is these neat things, these neat visuals, okay? And they're actually generated with your computer as part of the multiprocessor, shared processing, parallel computing thing. It's similar to how the SETI project uses a whole bunch of different people volunteering to give the free time when they're not using their computers to the SETI project to look for extraterrestrial activity. But here, you're actually donating some free time when you're not using your computer. It uses some of your CPU resources along with all these others to do a massive parallel computing thing, create those really neat visuals. So anyway, that's it, electricsheep.org. And it's a great screensaver, and you become famous for having musical interludes that have cool backgrounds. So someday. Like I do. All right, so let's see, what else do we have going on here? what else was I going to talk? Oh, that's right, I said I was going to do the Pixlr tutorial. So let's go ahead and pull a tab out, make it big, and go in here to Pixlr. And here we are. And first, though, I want to show you how, let me go ahead and get back to the, just briefly back to the mind map. Because I have also wanted to demonstrate how you get your images from your Google Photos. And so let me go up here to, where is it? There, Pixlr. And we're going to enhance the colors of a bad image this week in order to make an interesting image. So the image I happen to have over here. Oh, you don't even see what I'm talking about. Okay, so the image I happen to have in this link, and I'm going to click that link. Or actually, what I'll do is I'll copy this link and I'll paste it into the full thing. Copy link address, and I'm going to switch over to full screen. Okay, so you can see me do this. There we go. Mm-mm-mm. Yeah. All right. So this is the image. I'm over here at the, the Google, whatchamacallit, Google Photos thing. And I wanted you to see that here I am at Google Photos. And so there we go. Okay. So you see the, up there, you see the pencil and all that stuff. But you get your image, which here's this wonderful image, a really high-end image of a window that has someone threw rocks through near where I am. And I'm going to copy the image URL. You see how easy it is to get your pictures from Google Photos? Isn't it? This is just really cool. So, and you know what? I'm such a stickler for this. I gotta have it so it looks like I'm looking at the darn thing. Okay, there we have it. So you see that again, though. I simply right-click and say copy image URL, and you can get any of your pictures from your Google Photos. Just simple as this: copy image URL, and you go over to the Pixlr Editor. And let me move this out of the way. Oops, not that. This thing. There we go. And move up here. Sorry, cover you up there, Squarespace. And you get a create new image from URL, paste it in there, and hit OK. All right, there you have it. So let's go ahead and make this a little bigger, and I'll increase the zoom. Whee! Out of control. Okay. All right. Mr. Perfection here. All right, so now what are we going to do with this picture? I know, it's already so incredibly cool. I know what you're saying. God, Terry, don't touch it. It's so cool. But we're going to make it even cooler. Now, of course, I'm going to start out by making a duplicate of the layer so I can do all my messing on a copy. And that way I can blend the original with the manifestation that I come up with. So we're going to go up to... oh, let me see if I can get Zoom it working. Let's see. Oh, I didn't install it again. Another week that goes by that I did not bother installing Zoom it. I'm so sorry. Okay. All right. Okay. Yeah, I really should tell everybody about Zoom it too. Hey, well, a slight digression, folks. Just go to your Google thing, type in Zoom it. Oops. Zoom it. Z-O-O-M-I-T. And very top thing you see will be from TechNet. Go over there and just download it. It'll install the 64-bit and the other version in there. Just go ahead and extract it to anywhere. I'm going to extract it to my desktop. There we go. There we are. And now I have it on my desktop. I can close this out. Go find my desktop. Let's see, just hide everything. And there it is. And what it does is it lets you you agree to the stipulations, and now you create a keyboard shortcut that's going to start it up. I'm going to use Control Shift Z. Okay. And And I always hit run zoom it when Windows starts. So now in future shows, I will have this capability to do this. Oh, that doesn't look like much, does it? Okay, let's get our stuff back here. All right, so now I'll have the capability to do this. And I could zoom in even further, okay? And basically the way it works is wherever your arrow is, like I'm going to be up here at adjustments, and so now it zooms in, and as you move your mouse, it moves the whole thing around. So isn't that awesome? I say that's awesome. So, okay, so now you can get it too. I won't be the only one who's so cool. Yeah, I hate being alone. The only one who's cool. All right. Hey, you know, I'd be perfect if I didn't have such a problem with modesty. But we'll talk more about that later on when we get to the Tall Tales section of the show. All right, so let's go ahead. And all I'm going to do is do a hue saturation number on this picture. But what I wanted to kind of emphasize is that you don't have to only do stuff once. So I'm going to do there, and it's starting to look kind of nifty. Well, let's go up here to adjustment and do it again and turn it up all the way. And so, oh, look at that. Now it's starting to get almost painterly. And I'm going to do it again because I just, you know, didn't have enough subject material to talk about this week. And so, oh, look at this action. Oh, that is awesome. Oh, that is cool. I may stop there. You know, that's really cool. Well, we'll go and take a look at what one more hit will do and make a decision. That's interesting, but you know what? I think it's one of those quit while you're ahead types of things. Cause it's already there. Okay, so I'll make a compromise. No, it really is fine right where it was. Okay. So, I mean, there you go. And now, and look at that. I did do it to my original. I didn't make a duplicate. I got distracted and didn't make a copy. But there you go. There's the thing. That's the whole technique. Okay. So so isn't that awesome? And now let's say though, if we did go back and do it like we should have with duplicate layer, which is why I went to get zoom in, so I could zoom in on duplicate layer, and then I didn't. You then would do it all this mess to the copy. So we'll do it again because you love seeing me repeat this. And but look how bland and just not interesting. And now it's getting a little more interesting. I mean, it was just looked like a gray and white. Oops, that's color balance. I could mess with it too with that, but I really don't want to change the balance. I just want to emphasize the color that's already in there. So we took something that was practically a black and white photo, and by giving it three hits of the hue saturation and turning it up all the way, we wind up with something that's really kind of interesting. And you know, I really, because I do have the duplicate, one thing I probably should have demonstrated is go ahead and hit it too hard. And then I pull out this little button right here, the little arrows are, right there, okay? And I now have an opacity slider so I can mix it with the original and change how much I want it. And I can do a lot more than that. I can now make other copies of the background and like texturize that background and do other things and really mess with this and make it into quite a painterly looking little work piece. So now it looks like an interesting illustration to something, you know, whereas it did look just like this. And although it had some curiosity appeal, it didn't have the eye-popping wow factor that this has. Okay, so there, that's your whole trick, is the idea of applying these tools more than once at full saturation or full effect to see what else you can do. Okay, of course, like I said, I can duplicate this layer. I can go into other things. We haven't even discussed all the really cool filters that are in here. You have halftone filters, pixelating filters, swirling, all kinds of neat stuff. Let's get in there and take a look. So the glamour glow, the mimic HDR, art posters, heat maps, night visions, emboss and engrave, and find edges. Now, find edges is something that would probably be really cool for this particular application. And yet, you usually have to apply it a few times. But let's go ahead and now fade this back to see. That's what find edges does, okay? It makes it into a really, really interesting, like, drawing of what it was that you were working on. And so, and then I can take that and find edges again, and it get even more extreme. Like that. And so, all right, so you get the idea. So, bring this up again, and make some kind of a mix. Here we go. And now that it's getting very, very, looks like a drawing that's been colorized. Okay, so isn't that cool? Very cool. All right, so that's your Pixlr thing of the week. I'm going to go ahead and, because I like the layers, I may want to come back and fool with this again later. I'm going to save it as a layered piece. And so I'll give it a title, Windows. And rather than save it as a JPEG, which would just flatten all of the layers down, I'll go and save it as a PXD. And it's a large, makes it a little bit large, 4 megs, but that's not that big. And just go ahead and save that to my desktop again. There we go, desktop. And so now I have that hanging around. And it's a layered thing, so now when I load it in, my three layers are still going to be there for me to mess with, so I can work with more layers type of stuff. Okay, so let me just expose all my layers a little bit better. There you go. I usually expand this thing right away, because you very easily, once you start getting into duplicating layers and copying layers and pasting and doing all this stuff and making masks, you can wind up with a whole ton of layers. And so I usually start right out with expanding that thing. One thing you could do, of course, is take it where you have it at this stage and go ahead and flatten it now that you've saved the PXD, and you've saved those layers, and so you could flatten this and do some other treatment to it from this state. And various different ways that you can do this. You can flatten it, make a copy, unflatten it by using undo, and then paste in a thing a version of it you can mix in with the others in different ways. So anyway, there you go. More Pixlr action. Okay, so that's your Pixlr thing of the week. And remember, you get your stuff from like Google Photos. Very easy. You simply get a copy of the image URL and you're cooking. The places like Flickr make it a little stranger that you have to go through a little bit of a thing. If you already use Flickr, you're familiar with this, but you have to pick out which size you're going to use before you can get to the URL that you're going to paste in there. In order to get the full size, for instance, to paste in here, you have to go through a couple of different steps. But if you already use Flickr, you're familiar with that. Okay, so that's that. And so let's close this down and go back to get my comments up here. There we go. Oh yeah. Coloring book pages. It is a great way to make coloring book pages. Definitely, definitely. Without a doubt. So let me just flip myself. So I'm looking over here at the comments the right way. Oh yeah, there they are. And what else do we have going on in here? Da-da-da. Oh, great. Audio and visual aren't in time. How strange. Yeah, I noticed that happens with some people, but not everybody gets that. It might have something to do with how many different planets it bounces the signal to before it gets to people. I don't know. Oh, look at that. Now yours are out of sync. Okay, so watch this. Let's do this. Let's give it a try to see if it's in sync or not. Okay, so I'll clap on and count at the same time. One, two, three, four. Oh, okay, you know I'm being dumb. Okay, you know I'm aspiring ventriloquist. Watch this. I can actually say some things without moving my lips. Some things without losing eyelets. That didn't sound very. Okay. Well. All right, Phil Silversmith said, my image may be bad, but my color does not need enhancing. I use a professional makeup artist. Absolutely. Okay, so there you go. There's that thing. Oh my gosh, that must mean it's time for a musical interlude. Okay, good, because I got this keyboard set up I've been wanting to exploit. And in fact, I got even more than that, because I have some really cool patches in the works in here. And so let me switch banks. And yeah. I got my leads. I got some organs. I got some strange stuff. Okay. All right. So I'm going to switch over to start a musical interlude action. Let's see if I can make it happen. Da 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 da. Different reverb. Yeah. No. Just keyboards. No flute. I changed my mind. Thank you. Okie dokie, there's another flute keyboard interlude. Well, I hope you got some panning action for that with the stereo effect, because I'm working hard to get my little stereo mic thing working up here. Well, I sure hope that worked. Hey, if it didn't, I'm recording it this time for once, and also on the computer, so it's a disaster. Yeah, because I'm noticing every week I wind up with some dropout strings, at least one or two of the musical interludes, so what the heck. I gotta isolate some better patches to use on these other machines, but we'll see. We'll see what we wind up with today. Because this is all experimentation on as far as the keyboard's concerned. I got myself some new software, and I've been experimenting and putting all these new patches into the machines. The only one that's really kind of stabilized is the one you just heard, where I know I've got all my good arpeggiator patches in place to use for music interludes. I got that thing running on automatic. But I really want to isolate more of the things that had drums with them. And there is one in particular that is really, really cool. And in fact, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to. Now I'm going to start this. Let me close this. One in particular that I sort of wanted to look at was in this new MIDI Quest program that I just got. And I'm going to see if I can find this. It's called Earth. And East River is also great, but Earth, golly, that was a fine little items that had remarkable sound going on that I didn't expect. So let me see if I can find it in here. Da 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 da. Just be a second. Wouldn't you know? It must have been on the other machine. So let's look on VSR. And performance bank. Well, gee, you would think something as easy to spell as Earth I'd be able to find right away, but I'm not seeing it. I'm sorry. I really, really do want to use it. Cause, well, the reason I'm looking for it is because it's a drummy item. It's all drummy, and I really wanted to have some more drummy stuff in our world. So that's why I'm looking for it. And it doesn't look like it's going to jump off the page at me, because this is what I was going to prepare while I was running around the house trying to get everything else to work, and where nothing was working in the whole house. So. Let's take one last quick look. Oh, there it is. I found it. It's patch number 23, Earth. All right. Well, I'll go ahead and do something with that. Okay. Here we go. And I don't know what I'll do with this. There we are. And I know it just will have gone to off. There. Okay. So let's go ahead. I'm ready for another musical interlude. I really need it after all of that panicking earlier. I need it. So I'm going to try this thing out. Let's see if I can make it work. Okay, there we go.
It's drummy. I may as well have my flute on my lap in case I use it. These things. Okay. Oh my gosh, it's coming out of the speakers.
Is it? What the heck? Good grief. What have I done to myself? Yeah. But now I don't hear my... Oh my gosh. What's going on here? I'm sorry. I'll be right back. I've set everything up wrong. What next? There, I'll be right back. I gotta turn off something off. It looks, oh, I unplugged my headphones, which is all I needed. Be right back. I'm gonna turn off these speakers. Okay, there we go. Okay, so we need a musical interlude. Yes. All right. So sorry. We need a musical interlude to the music to the musical interlude. So that was your musical interlude, but I don't hear a thing. So okay, let's try it again, because everything was broken a minute ago. Now everything's working. Okay, here goes. Let's try to get this cables out of the way. There we go. Yes, Melanie caught me last week at this thing of my facing away from the keyboards. Try not to do that this week. Okay, and the key of D minor, hold on, you expect not much. Thank you. This, things couldn't be strange, a little stranger than what they just were. The keyboards are out of tune with each other now. Don't ask me what I did. Okay, let's turn this down. Okay, at least those two are in tune. But the upper one had that sound with a full half step out of tune. So here I am playing in D, thinking, oh, everything's merry. I'll play in D on the keyboard. And it was actually in D flat on the rest of the keyboards. So I have to find out what the heck that's about. What did I do? Oh, well, who knows? There's your flute, your interlude for the day. Let's go to the videotape. Oh, look at this. Ah, you can hear flute, but I'm not playing the flute. That's the way it should be. Okay, so what the heck? Let me switch the old camera around. Shame that I can have this just be a permanent setting, but I can't. Actually, wait a minute. Maybe I can. Hey, let me try something. I seem to remember I can grab a scene and pull it around. You're going to see this live, folks. And yank it. No, it's not that. It's not that one. Yeah. Resize. There it is. No, that's just resize. Crop? I'm going to have to redo this. No, that's not it. Oh, well. I don't know what I'm fantasizing, but sort of remembered that I could actually flip the whole image around just by dragging it somehow, but I don't remember how the heck that was done. Might be, who knows? Da-da-da-da-da. So what do we do next? Let's see. Let me look over here at these things. And, the music stopped and started again. Yes. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's so funny. Oh, no. What's going on? I don't see anything that would be causing a delayed playback, so I better go look for such a thing. Let me see. It says my signal is good. I haven't had anything bad in a while, so who knows? This is funny. I'm not playing back any audio anyway. Don't think so. Look at that. We had a whole bunch of bad streams though. Okay, well, anyhow, talking in the string bass is blasting that way. Huge delay from video to sound. All right, and let's see, we'll do the old clap thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, there you go. Backed up 2 minutes, oh my gosh. Oh man, this is too crazy. Well, I'm dropping frames. Right now I just dropped a ton of frames. Oh, it's dropped like 35,000 frames. So tonight's show is a disaster in terms of fidelity. And it's just a total disaster. I don't know why. Why do I go on? Because it's dropping frames like mad again. And it's just, I doubt you're even hearing what I'm saying. It's not giving me a bad yet. It's telling me health is good, but I can see it dropping frames. I'm getting a 24% frame drops. And then it'll all of a sudden stabilize again. So on YouTube's end, I guess I'm going to have to blame their end because it's just too intermittent. Yeah, it's all over the place. All right, well, they are doing a bunch of labs. They're doing a bunch of changeovers, so they must be messing with my head. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, something's afoot on the plus. That's what I say. So, amazing we're getting through this program. All right, well, what else do we have going on in the show? Messing with us. It's not me. All right, let's see what else we got tonight. We got the bad image. Good thing we got that stuff working while the show's still going, because I'm showing such bad, I mean, really bad. In fact, it even says bad. Oh, look at this action. Okay, it even says B-A-D, bad, bad, Terry, bad. And so they're not receiving enough video data fast enough. And I can see that they're right, because it goes into the red constantly on my OBS. And, you know, this is a total panic. I have no idea why. And I can even show you, in fact, I can demonstrate by sharing this actual screen. Here, I'll do that. And let's see, it's the lower screen. It's not the upper. Oh, it's the lower screen. Well, now it's decided not to show me that correctly. So, if it's not one thing, it's another. And if it's not another, then it'll be the third thing. All right, well, all I can say is, since this is Disasterville over here, let's go ahead and we'll just keep messing with the... trying to do a show. Yeah. Oh, no, don't do that. There we go. Okay. Don't play, please. There we go. Okay, good. Da-da-da, da-da-da. Okay, get that out of the way. I want to see my badge. It says it's good for now, but I know it's not. It's really bad. It's super bad. It's like so many dropped frames. It's unreal. Okay. Well, let's see what else we can do with the show. So I wanted to. I showed you this part. I did want to go over some of the archive stuff, and so this is a good week to do that, since we have such terrible things. We may as well talk about the reruns. Yeah, because that's what I should have done with this show. And show number 16 is starting in reruns already. So anyhow, I figured I'd go over some of the stuff that we've covered in the past. So in YouTube features, we've covered sprucing up your YouTube channel, YouTube playbook courses, the uses of annotations, mixing the video with Creative Commons licensed content. In other words, making your own video out of like one of my videos or anybody else that's Creative Commons licensing. That's not the standard YouTube copyright. It's the new one. So look at this action. It's unbelievable. You know, I just can't believe you guys are even seeing anything. It's like so unstable. It's so unstable. I'm going to stop this show and start it again, okay? And be right back. Okay? I'm going to be right back. Da, 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 da. Oh, I'd stop recording too. Or maybe not. Change to 25. And 25. Maybe that'll help. All right. All right. Well, I lowered the quality of the stream. The audio will still be good, but I lowered the video quality. Not that like I really need high video quality for this kind of program. And maybe that'll help things stabilize a little bit, in considering what the conditions are. All righty. Anyway, ta-da. So we had all these different things: YouTube editor tricks, transcription cleanup and reuse, and look at this. And this is in the wrong place, right here. This belongs there. Okay, and we did the lowering your CPU usage in OBS streams, which was another video. In fact, that video exists on YouTube. I did a separate video on that in my YouTube channel. Okay, and the monetization, what did we talk about besides the fact that I mentioned Patreon tonight? Well, we talked about Udemy and the OV, the Online Video Educators and Entrepreneurs Community over at Google+. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a post inside of the Google, the Blue Juice Jubilee community page. And I'll make a post of all the different links that we've ever mentioned in the shows, okay? So we'll have this kind of little archive of all the past links that we've gone and explored or visited and stuff like that. I think that would be a cool addition for that thing. So yes, we talk about Udacity, Udemy, the fact that there's a, if you're going to try to do a startup or want to learn how to be a startup business, that there's a free course over at Udacity, for instance. But Udacity is mostly programmer classes. Talk about YouTube ad revenue. And look at this, I'm bad again. I'm bad. Oh no, I'm good. I saw it read something in red and it threw me. Okay, so yeah, you have Fedora, lets you do Udacity, Udemy type classes, you include Udemy class in your web page. Same with Thinkific, lets you bring those classes over and also do it as your own marketing on your own website where you're in full control. And we talked about other paid content where people, you know, pay through YouTube, pay for content. If you have, I think that was the one where you had to have enough people, 1,000 subscribers. And then YouTube fan donations, which is a new feature that they got. Okay. So also in the archives, we have the Pixlr things where we talked about opening an image into Pixlr from desktop URL and from a library, using the copy in the history with flattened layers, which we always go over. It seems I must mention that every single time. Tour of the PixlrTemplates.com where I have all those templates. YouTube live events masks, colorizing black and white images. We used that ballroom that we colorized from Wikipedia. Using the rubber stamp tool to kind of fill in gaps and fix broken spots. Making good selections for masks, making a copy on a layer to make a selection from, and doing all kind of cool stuff. I remember we did feathering by making a copy of a selection, filling it with some black, taking away the selection, blurring that, and then making the selection again, and that made a softer edge to the selection for our mask. Okay, and the making use of bad images archives, where we made them spooky, made use of background layer texture, changed the colors, warped it out, cropped the hell out of them, enlarging and sharpening them, increased their contrast. We used the magic wand with a high contrast image in order to put a new sky in the background of that one picture, for instance, where it was just a white sky because of the way the exposure had messed with everything to get the darker stuff and the trees and the river and everything in front of this building. It opened way up, and so it blew out the sky, so the sky was just white. So we put a different sky in its place. And we combine interesting detail with another picture. Okay, so anyway, that's some of the things that we did in the past. So that means it's time for another musical interlude. Oh, okay. Geez, Terry, you're just so, you know, so into these musical interlude things. I mean, I really surprised myself. Okay, all right. So let's go ahead and try to do something on the keyboards. Okay. I'm going to try to do something on the keyboards. So let's go ahead and do just keyboards.
Thank you.
Okie doke, here we go. Back to reality, back to reality. Hi. You know, when I'm just exploring these patches, I have no idea what I'm going to wind up in, so we're lucky we get anything at all out of there. And look at this thing. Look at this action. Okay, well, it looks like the stream didn't stop, but I'm still getting all kinds of warning messages and... 10 minutes of good here, 3 minutes of good there. Who knows? Anyway, it's recording, so not a total waste if I lose the thing. I'll just upload this recording. We'll get a partial show. I'll mix the two things together of how the show started and mix that with this and get kind of the disaster show. Yes. Well, you know, number 16 is supposed to be that way. You know, it's a magic number to the founders of the Constitution. They thought the number 16 was like all about everything. So someday look up founders of Constitution number 16 and get an earful of like, what? They thought this about the number 16? What is their problem? Anyhow. So, gosh, this is like... So, the streamer stops... Oh, you never seen the streamer stop streaming here like I did. Mm-hmm. Right. What I did was I actually did stop the stream from my end. I turned off OBS. I dropped the quality level down to 2,500 from 3,000 or 3,500. And hoping it would stay more stable, but it has. It's a little more stable. It's down to 9.5% dropped frames. But still, already 2,823 dropped frames. That's, you know, that's ridiculous. Anyway, just not a good night for streaming, I guess. What can I say? But I'm not going to panic. Yes, I am panicking inside, but I'm strong on the outside. Okay, so let's see. What else are we going to talk about? Oh, we have to talk about... I definitely wanted you to hear my poem. So I hope this thing lasts and doesn't break up and go away. Because I'm going to do the Paul Bunyan poem. Okay, so why don't I just go ahead and... Whoops, that's not what I wanted... Yeah, that's what I wanted to do. No, that's not what I wanted to do. Okay. Oh, yeah, that's fine. That's what I wanted to do. All right, so famous children's poems. So let's go ahead and expand this. This is a website that has all these family poems, supposedly, you know, that are safe to share with your children. And, so this version of the poem is from Shel Silverstein's book of poems for children, Where the Sidewalk Ends, published in 1974. A slightly different version of Paul is sung by Bobby Bear in his 1973 album, Lullabies, Legends, and Lies. He begins with an introduction. You know, American folklore is filled with legendary characters like Billy the Kid, Johnny Appleseed, Pecos Bill, and probably the greatest one of all has got to be Paul Bunyan, cause he was the meanest and the biggest and the dirtiest tobacco chewinest and the funkiest and the best wood chopper of all of them. Paul Bunyan is a lumberjack of huge size and strength in American folk tales. Usually included in these tall tales is his companion, Babe the Blue Ox. And so, yes, I am featuring Babe the Blue Ox in my feature, because I'm featuring him. And I'm going to read the story, Babe the Blue Ox, in a minute. Okay, so let's go ahead here to the poem. Paul Bunyan by Shel Silverstein. He rode through the woods on a big blue ox. He had fists as hard as chopping blocks. 500 pounds and 9 feet tall. That's Paul. Talk about working. When he swung his axe, you could hear it ring for a mile and a half. Then he'd yell, timber, and down she'd fall. For Paul. Talk about drinking. That man's so mean that he'd never drink nothing but kerosene. And a 5-gallon can is a little bit small. For Paul. Talk about tough. Well, he once had a fight with a thunderstorm on a cold, dark night. And I ain't saying who won, but it don't storm at all round here. thanks to Paul. He was 90 years old when he said with a sigh, I think I'm gonna lay down, right down and die. 'Cause sunshine and sorrow, I've seen it all, says Paul. He says, there ain't no man alive can kill me. Ain't no woman round can thrill me. And I think heaven just might be a ball, says Paul. So he died, and we cried. It took 18 men just to bust the ground. It took 24 more just to lower him down. And we covered him up, and we figured that was all for Paul. But late one night, the trees started shaking, the dogs started howling, and the earth started quaking. And out of the ground, with a hi, y'all, comes Paul. He shook the dirt from off his clothes, he scratched his butt and wiped his nose. You know, being dead was no fun at all, said Paul. He says, up in heaven they got harps on their knees. They got clouds and wings, but they got no trees. I don't think that's much of a heaven at all, says Paul. So he jumps in his ox with a fare-thee-well. He says, I'll find out if there's trees in hell. And he rode away, and that was all we ever seen of Paul. Well, the next time you hear a timber yell that sounds like it's coming from the pits of hell, then a weird and devilish ghostly wail like somebody's chopping on the devil's tail, then a shout, a call, a crash, a fall. That ain't no mortal man at all. That's Paul. So there you go. Okay, that's your Paul Bunyan poem. Okay. Oh, yeah, oh, yeah. Because you have to have a good poem. Oh, good, the audio's clear. Well, the audio should be good. Even though I dropped the video quality, the audio should be good. Okay. Hey, look, it's got me to protest him back before all the freezing and all the crisis and the catastrophes, started up again. Anyway, yeah. So you missed a whole bunch of excitement. Yeah, yeah. Okay, well, I'm glad it's started. Look at this. I love this action with this, though, where it just starts playing and people are getting these huge delays. Let me know if you're getting the huge delays, Scott. Yeah. So, okay. So anyway, there's your Paul Bunyan poem. And see, I'm better educated now about Paul Bunyan. I had to be because it was really getting bad that I couldn't even, everybody was doing circles around me in the plus word game. Because I forgot all about my Paul Bunyan stuff. Terrible. What kind of an American am I? Anyway, this American folklore page is really cool. That I'm going to read this other story from. And it's got all kinds of stories. It's got the Pecos Bill. It's got the basics of the Br'er Rabbit and all the others. I'll show you that in a second. In fact, why don't we just go right ahead, right to it, since we're on the subject of Paul Bunyan. We'll go right to the subject of Paul Bunyan. We'll stay on it, since I have my stream is staying solid for the moment. So let's go ahead and let's find that thing. It's called Paul Bunyan and Babe the Blue Ox. So let's see what happens over here. So it's the American Folklore page. It's at AmericanFolklore.net. And this particular story, well, most of these stories, I don't know if it was, can't be for copyright reasons, because all these are public domain, but most of these were retold by S.E. Schlosser, who I have a feeling is behind this site. But you see on the left side, you've got all these famous characters that they've got the various stories from. And they also have ghost stories with campfire type stories and funny ghost stories and folk tales. So it's really quite a little resource for looking at the Americana type of stuff. But let me just go ahead and see if I can't get this website a little bit bigger. Oh. Well, it doesn't look like it's responsive enough. I think this will work. And maybe one back. Here we Oops. No, back. I said back, back, back. Okay, there we go. Okay, see, now you can see it too. All right. Oh, Babe the Blue Ox. So let me take a little drink. Mm-hmm. All righty. Babe the Blue Ox, Minnesota Tall Tales, retold by S.E. Schlosser. Well now, one winter it was so cold that all the geese flew backward and all the fish moved south and even the snow turned blue. Late at night it got so frigid that all spoken words froze solid afore they could be heard. People had to wait until sunup to find out what folks were talking about the night before. Well, Paul Bunyan went out walking in the woods one day during that winter of the blue snow. He was knee-deep in blue snow when he heard a funny sound between a bleat and a snort. Looking down, he saw a teeny-tiny baby blue ox just a-hopping about in the snow and snorting with a rage on account of he was too short to see over the drifts. Paul Bunyan laughed when he saw the spunky little critter and took the little blue mite home with him. He warmed the little ox up by the fire, and the little fellow fluffed and up and dried out, but he remained as blue as the snow that had stained him in the first place. So Paul named him Babe the Blue Ox. Well, any creature raised in Paul Bunyan's camp tended to grow to massive proportions, and Babe was no exception. Folks that stared at him for 5 minutes could see him growing right before their eyes. He grew so big that 42 axe handles plus a plug of tobacco could fit between his eyes. And it took a murder of crows a whole day to fly from one horn to the other. The laundryman used his horns to hang up all the camp laundry, which would dry lickety-split because of all the wind blowing around at that height. Whenever he got an itch, Babe the Blue Ox had to find a cliff to rub against, because whenever he tried to rub against a tree, it fell over and begged for mercy. To whet his appetite, Babe would chew up 30 bales of hay, wire and all. It took 6 men with picaroons to get all the wire out of Babe's teeth after his morning snack. Right after that, he'd eat a ton of grain for lunch and then come pestering around the cook, Sourdough Sam, begging for another snack. Babe the Blue Ox was a great help around Paul Bunyan's logging camp. He could pull anything that had two ends, so Paul often used him to straighten out the pesky, twisted logging roads. By the time Babe had pulled the twists and kinks out of all the roads leading to the lumber camp, there was 20 miles of extra road left, flopping about with nowhere to go. So Paul rolled them up and used them to lay a new road into a new timberland. Paul also used Babe the Blue Ox to pull the heavy tank wagon, which was used to coat the newly straightened lumber roads with ice in the winter. Until one day, the tank sprang a leak that trickled south and became the Mississippi River. After that, Babe stuck to hauling logs. Only he hated working in the summertime. So Paul had to paint the logging roads white after the spring thaw so that Babe would keep working through the summer. One summer, as Babe the Blue Ox was hauling a load of logs down the whitewashed road and dreaming of the days when the winter would feel cold again and the logs would slide easier on the ice, he glanced over the top of the mountain and caught a glimpse of a pretty yeller calf grazing in a field. Well, he twisted out of his harness lickety-split and stepped over the mountain to introduce himself. It was love at first sight, and Paul had to abandon his load and buy Bessie the yeller cow from the farmer before Babe would do any more hauling. Bessie the yeller cow grew to the massive yet dainty proportions that were suitable for the mate of Babe the Blue Ox. She had long yellow eyelashes that tickled the lumberjack standing on the other end of the camp each time she blinked. She produced all the dairy products for the lumber camp. Each day, Sourdough Sam made enough butter from her cream to grease the giant pancake griddle, and sometimes there was enough left over to butter the toast. The only bone of contention between Bessie and Babe was the weather. Babe loved the ice and snow, and Bessie loved warm summer days. One winter, Bessie grew so thin and pale that Paul Bunyan asked his clerk, Johnny Inkslinger, to make her a pair of green goggles so she would think it was summer. After that, Bessie grew happy and fat again, and produced so much butter that Paul Bunyan used the leftovers to grease the whitewashed lumber roads in summer. With the roads so slick all year round, hauling logs became much easier for Babe the Blue Ox, and so Babe eventually came to like summer almost as much as Bessie. So there's your tall tale for the day. And yes, good old Silverstein, huh? Yeah? He's really... Oh, there we go. Okay. No, thanks, Michael. And there's Babe. So, okay. Cool, cool, cool. Oh, yes, and yes, there's the Disney version of the Paul Bunyan story. I've forgotten all about it till I was doing some searching for the stories, and in the YouTube... Yeah, the YouTube video of this popped into place right on the search page. So you search for Paul Bunyan and Babe the Blue Ox, and you'll see the video. So, okay. Oh, good. That's a good thing. Make some bread while listening and learning about Paul Bunyan. Okay. So, awesome, awesome. And that's what Paul looked like, all right. Now, all over the country, of course, you have these giant, giant statues that are about 20, 30 feet tall of Paul Bunyan's all over the place. And we had one at the Great Danbury State Fair up in Connecticut. We're in Fairfield County, Connecticut, Danbury, Connecticut. They also were repurposed as some tire company that sells tires. Paul Bunyan's were repurposed. So the same company that made the giant Paul Bunyan's also made these giant tire guys holding, instead of an axe, they were holding something. I don't even remember what they were holding. But anyway, I was surprised because I was doing research on the original, on the Paul Bunyan that had been at the fair, and found out this bit of trivia about the company that made Paul Bunyan statues. And they're all over the country. It's part of this car, this tire company or something, some automotive thing. Anyway, trivia. Yeah. All right, so what should I do now? Gee, I don't know what I should do. Golly. Because I have no idea what sounds are in these computers anymore. I do know I like digital, but I loved this one sound I really, really liked. Let's see. What was it? Robin of Sherwood. Ah, there's the sound for you. And Wild Thing, of course. Well, see, I just have to explore some of these sounds I got in here now. I just loaded a whole bunch of new sounds that I really didn't know much about. And I just had to, like, check them out. Yeah, oh my gosh, look at all this stuff. Ah, there's the East River. Okay, well, I'm going to try that sound. And let's see, something else up here. Bush. Grand piano. I don't know. Who knows what's going to happen. All right, well, let's do a musical interlude now that we've had the poetry and story reading. And I'll tell another story, because it's still in the theme of tall tales. Okay, so let's go ahead and go to performance mode and switch the camera so I'm not looking away from the keyboard. Here we go. Okay, let's see if I what the heck I have in here. Let me see. I'm going to try to, I might just give up and do a arpeggiator thing, but who knows. Da 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 da. This one.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. Change the sound. All right. Okay. All right, that was fun. A little of everything in there. Well, I got the other sense working. Yeah, I have to stretch a little bit. It'll reach this one way over here. But, oh, yeah, it's amazing. I'm amazed myself what I do with the keyboard sometimes, especially when I play really badly. But, no, that was okay. I'm even just about happy with that. Tiny T-Rex Britton. Oh, yes, everyone likes the hands thing. Yes, you know, this is what he's referring to, is the little hands, you know, reach over there. So, okay. Well, yes. Well, I wanted to fit the whole keyboard in there, so, you know, that's what I did. Okay, so let's see what else is going on. Wait, by the way, just so you know, I am such a fan of Dinosaur Train, so that's why the T-Rex arms, okay? That is why. Okay. Okay, oh, look at that, Mr. Tire, that's what it is, Mr. Tire! These Mr. Tires are all over the planet. Yeah, I understand the one that used to be at the Danbury State Fair now resides somewhere in upstate New York on Highway 9 or something. I don't know. Or Route 22. I don't know. Something up there in upstate New York. Okay, so. Ta-da. Let's see. So what else can we talk about? Geez, we've done all the interesting stuff. Well, I was going to show how to fade in and fade out a track in Audacity, and you know we have enough time to do that. So let me bring up Audacity, and if I have it loaded in. Wait a minute, where did I go? Oh, God, I reset my computer. I might not even have it installed now. Let me see. No, it doesn't look like it. Looks like I took it out. Sure enough, I uninstalled it. What a maroon. Okay, so, well, so let me show you how to install Audacity. In fact, actually, that's a long time coming, because last time I tried to show how to install Audacity, it was ridiculous. So let me go ahead and I'm going to bring this into a new tab and make it full screen and change my screen to this one. Okie dokie. And, of course, I have to switch the camera. And there we go. Okay. So, yeah, this is Audacity. So you go to Audacity. And it's funny how A-U-D-A-C-I-T-Y. Okay, Audacity. And you say Audacity download, Audacity whatever. It'll take it right at the very tip top. It'll be Audacity. And it's at SourceForge. I just always go to the Audacity website, you know, right away. I go to audacityteam.org. And here it is. Audacity for Windows, and so I click on that and I go get it, and so here it is for Windows, and so the latest version, Windows 2.1 installer, and it downloads it. I keep it and it installs. Okay, so this is the easy part, very fast. Okay, so we'll just go ahead and do this. The neat thing about it is it doesn't put any kind of garbage stuff in your thing. I'm not going to reset the preferences. I already have some stuff in that folder because I had it installed before, but I did a system restore and it removed all those things that I installed since. So, well, I couldn't get the Cakewalk and the MIDI Quest working together, so I panicked. Okay, so it has a little bit of information and you launch Audacity. And here's Audacity. So it's found a bunch of plugins. So if you have a bunch of plugins, it goes and finds them and says, okay, well, I got all these plugins that I might be able to use. And so it tests them all and sees if it can use it. These are mostly VST type plugins. And so they're little plugins you can use as special effects and effect units and stuff like that. Some of them are instruments. And so sometimes you can actually use instruments. All right, now here you have this Audacity screen now shows up, and you immediately run into your preferences, and you go down here to where it says files, libraries, okay? So let me just zoom in on there. It says libraries. See that? And you see it says MP3 library, not found, and it says locate, or you can go download it. This is for your lame to make your own MP3s. So you click on download and it zips you over to here where it shows you how for Mac OS X or Windows how to get these files. So you on Windows you click on this link, and this for some reason eluded me the first time I did this, like the second week of the show or something. I couldn't see this link to save my life. You click on that link, it takes you to this oddball looking page, and here's the lame for Audacity exe. So you run it and you get it down here, and it's a very tiny file, and you load it in. And what it's going to do is it's going to make, it's actually lame, it's the version that's suited for Audacity, so it puts itself already in the correct folder so that Audacity will be able to find it. So you do all the little clicky clicks, and it's done very, very fast. So now I go to Audacity, and I click locate, and bingo, it finds it right there, and see it. The MP3 library version lame 399.3. Okay, same thing with the FFmpeg. Now if you wanted to bring in your downloaded YouTube videos that are in MP4 format and just get the audio to process, you'll need this thing. You'll definitely need this. So again, you can locate, and I know it's in there, but I'm going to show you how to download again. So it's actually on the same page but it's right here. So you get right below the lame is the FFmpeg binary, okay? Compatible with Audacity 2.06, which this is the latest Audacity, so this is later, or later. So you just go and get this one right here, 2.2.2, okay? And because it's right there, and on the same page. And the same thing over here for Mac OS X, you get lame and FFmpeg from down there. So this downloads this amazing program. It has all these different file conversion routines in it, and lets you bring in audio from a whole lot of oddball formats that you wouldn't have even known you would have the capability. But it lets you load in your MP3s directly, load in an MP4 video file, and automatically extracts the audio from that video so that you can edit the audio. So I just click on that so it opens, it's ready, and it'll pop open, and bingo, whoop. And it says, "Well, you want me to do this?" Yes. And say English. Yes. Next. Next. And I know the folder's already there, but I'm just doing it, and hit install. Okay. So now that's done. And so you go back to Audacity, and now you say locate right here. And you see, it says FFmpeg library not found, but I'm going to find it very quickly. And there we go. And so it finds it. All right, so now you're all set to be able to import any kind of video or audio. So you can import right here audio, and so this allows you to actually import audio not just from WAV files and other recordings, MP3s, but also right from your video. So you can download a video from your YouTube page and import it. Okay, so let's go ahead and import some kind of audio that I got somewhere. Let's see if I got any audio around here. Let's see. Don't even know actually if I've got. Oh, I've got tons of audio. So let's see. Let's find something that would be something that I could edit that'd be useful to edit. Well, this is huge. It's huge. It's really gigantic. That's what I was going to play tonight, in fact. Well, it doesn't really matter what I do. So let's just get this in here. I'm going to choose make a copy of the files before editing. And what it does is copies the whole file. And so now I have this right here. So notice it starts really right here, really abrupt. I'm going to use my little magnifying plus sign to kind of blow it up. And so I've got this little, I'm going to take off this noise right here by selecting it and hitting the delete key. But now I'm going to make a little bit of a fade in right here. So it doesn't just start right off with me playing. I'm going to give it a little bit of a fade. And the way you do that is go to Effect, and lo and hold, fade in. And so you click that, and it does it. It does it. Bingo, it's already done, okay? So I don't know if you can see what difference it made, but it made a nice fade in. So let's go ahead and do the undo, and undo fade in. Well, I'll just use the shortcut key, undo. So you see, there's where it did the fade in. Do Control Y to return it. So Control Z undoes, Control Y redoes. Okay, so you can do a comparison. And you can do more. And the more you select, the slower the fade in is. Same thing on the other end of the audio is you have the fade out. So looks like I got a whole bunch of quiet, very quiet playing on this thing. But the same idea. You select the audio that you want to have fade out, and you just go to effect, fade out, and it puts it in there for you, and it's done. Now this is really useful when you're doing audio stuff that's going to segue from one thing to another, or doing music cuts where you're having the music cut out, is if you want to have it do a bit of a fade. So if you're using any of these music pieces from, let's just close this. If you want to use any of these music pieces from the YouTube side of things, let's see if I can find the, I wonder if I left that open. Why didn't that? Oh, that's that YouTube. Okay. I guess I didn't leave that open because I kept replacing it. Let's see. Zoom. There it is. All right, so I have my audio library. I got my free music. Oh, we didn't cover the free music of the week. Okay, so let me go to my favorites. And I don't know if this is going to work because I couldn't hear a thing before, but Ambient Ambulance is the free music of the week. So, but I don't know if we're going to hear anything. Oh, of course we're not. We're definitely not, because I have the I have the audio turned off. So let me just shrink this page down and turn this on for going out to the show. There we go, and for my ears too. All right, good. Okay, so let's see if I can hear this sound effect now. Oh, that's great. I'm gonna hit this button. There we go. And not sound effects. There we go. Nothing like it. I wonder if I'll ever get this playing. Oh, there we go. It's finally working. Let me increase the volume. It's pretty quiet. Yeah, it's quiet. Not a very loud piece. Here we go. So I upped the trim so you can hear it a little better. But that's your, this is a bit of music, so let's go ahead and, but this started out so slow, it's like, what's there to fade in or fade out of this thing? It fades in already. Anyway, but it's a really, it's a nice little background for doing things. That's something that's got, that's another sound that we've used. That fades in. Oh, Hill's Behind. Yeah, but that's not a good candidate for a fade in. Well, probably for a fade out, though, because if I wasn't going to use the whole piece, I would be able to use this thing. So let's go ahead and bring this into Audacity. It's in my downloads. So we're all going to import audio. Okay. And go to downloads. Let's see, it's going to have to be up. And where the heck is it? Up one more. Oh, this crazy computer. There it is. And I just got this piece, so date modified is the sort. And you see, it's bringing in an MP3 file in this case. So now I have this grand opening. And so I have my little announcement. I'm recording my announcement. And so this would be a good place for me to just probably go ahead and back this thing up and make a new recording. So, okay. So we're wondering all the time if this thing's recording, and it's not. So good thing I checked, because it's not even recording. Well, okay, that's because I have those settings all wrong. Wouldn't you know it? All right, but, so let's imagine right about here in this area, because we are not recording. Nothing's recording. recording, Terry. All right. At least we can hear it. Ta-da. Okay, so we recorded nothing. File, undo, record. I had the wrong input is most likely what it is. Let's see. Analog 1 and 2. See, yes, there we go. Okay, so let's go ahead and... On top of the world, Paul Bunyan and his babe, the Blue Ox, conquering all and meeting really nice yellow cows. So, will they continue this escapade? We'll find out next week in part 2 of Paul Bunyan and Babe the Blue Ox. Okay, so now we have this text. And so now I would select in here where the music's going to fade out. And I probably would shorten this massively, of course, and go up here to Effect, Fade Out. And see, because I really have too much, it's going to be the super, super slow fade. So that's not what I want. So let's go ahead and cut a bunch of this out. Hit the delete key. And now I'll make my selection, and it's a much shorter selection. Make it a little teeny thing. There we go. And so now the length of the fade is going to be relative to that. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a listen at this.
On top of the world, Paul Bunyan and his babe, the Blue Ox, conquering all.
Stop it.
Really nice yellow cows. So,
all right.
Will they...
All right, so I don't even know what I'm doing here. Okay, so let's...
On top of the world, Paul Bunyan and his babe, the Blue Ox.
Call this to get to a fade in. Fade out,
really
I mean.
Nice yellow cows. So, will they continue this escapade? We'll find out next week in part 2 of Paul Bunyan and Babe the Blue Ox.
So you see how nice it fades out there? And so I did the cut, and I made a nice fade out. Now, of course, I'm a little pissed off at how bad this sounds. I mean, this sounds awful. So I probably should show you that in these effects are also many other things, like a bass and treble control, and equalization, a compressor, that you can do a whole lot with. So I can change the threshold. Let's just do a preview and see if...
On top of the world, Paul Bunyan.
Nothing. I didn't do nothing. So we'll drop this here, and we'll up this ratio to something crazy, and now preview.
On top of the world, Paul Bunyan and his...
Oh, yeah, that sounds even better, you see? And so I'm going to take this noise floor. Well, the noise floor is fine. And I'm going to lower that threshold even more. And there we go. And so I've compressed it, and now I'm going to add EQ. And so I use EQ and get some equalization. And I'm just going to boost up the bass. Oops, oops, oops. Come on now, draw curves. There we go. All right, that's what I want. Boost that, keep that down there. And let's preview.
On top of the world, Paul Bunyan and his...
There we go. So it's even crazier. So I can draw curves. I can drop this down and get rid of some of the high end. And roll it off. And I can boost this up even more. And I'm going to say that's okay. So you see it changed aspects of it. I may have to lower the volume.
On top of the world, Paul Bunyan and his babe, the Blue Ox, conquering all and meeting really nice yellow cows. So, will they continue this escapade? We'll find out next week in part 2 of Paul Bunyan and Babe the Blue Ox.
I can't wait. Okay, so as you see, and I then cut off some of the noise that's here at the end, and I cut off that little squeak that's here in the beginning. But the problem with doing this little squeak is that if I hit delete now, it's going to close up to the end. So instead I'm going to use the generate silence and see it just generate silence instead of turning that thing off. Okay. So let's undo the, there we go.
On top of the world, Paul Bunyan.
So there you go, that's the idea. Okay. So there's your Audacity lesson for today. And I don't need to change, save that. Okay, great, great, great. Ta-da! So, so there we have it, there we have it. Oh, what's this? Music play. Okay, well, it's time for the grand finale. So, this action. Notes? Okay, well, I'm glad, Andrew, see you later. Well, okay, so we covered a whole bunch of stuff. We did get some of it done in spite of all the various catastrophes. Right now, I have the show, it's telling me that I don't even have, you know, that I'm bad again. So I do have the recording, though, of this show. See, I'm bad. So, and I lowered the stream down really, really far. So I have no idea why this is all going on. It's really pathetic. But, so I'm not even going to do a closing music thing, because if it's this bad, then I'm just not getting any stream. There's nothing going out the door. Nothing getting out of here. So you probably missed all that whole Audacity tutorial. But nonetheless, thank you everybody for coming this week, and thanks for sticking it out and putting up with all the nonsense. I am going to be putting up some more recordings in the conceptual music section where I've been pulling the other videos for the intro videos, because I've got like three or four performance things that were all done the same way where it was live composing, okay? And it's, so I may as well throw them on a neat background with the electric sheep and throw them up on YouTube so you can have those listened to too. And once in a while I'll be able to recycle those and use those as the intro music thing instead of the ones that we've been listening to, because we've pretty much been using the same three over and over again. I know it's an hour long. Who could tell? But nonetheless, we're going to have that. So join the Blue Juice Jubilee community. The link's over there in the description. And I'm going to be posting a lot more stuff and getting a lot more action going on in that community over the next couple of weeks. So again, thanks for sticking out with the show. If we had too many dropouts and it was too disgusting, I did start a recording after the first music piece. So what I'll probably do is download the MP3 after it's done processing and splice it together with the recording that I made, and then upload the whole thing brand new, and I'll put that link into the event page instead, and into the Blue Juice Jubilee community. All right, so you'll have those different links to the improved show without dropouts, hopefully. Okay, well, thanks a million for coming, and okay, I hear the complainers. Like, Terry, you can't do this to us. I hear it. I hear you. Okay. All right, let's see. All right, I'll do an outro. I'll do an outro music thing. It's going to be another... it's going to be another... some of the font, the names of these things here. It's going to be another arpeggiator thing. But next week, I've got some major rhythmy things coming up that make what we did today look like nothing. Okay? So, all right. So, good night, everybody. Thanks again for coming. And here's your outro music thing. Okay, kind of a mellow outro this week. Well, previous weeks have been so raucous. I figured I better, you know, for some people that don't appreciate raucous outros, maybe I better do one mellow one. Okay, so there's your mellow outro for the week. Thanks again for everybody for coming, and hopefully the recording came out okay, and everything will be dropout free, and it just was an enjoyable show for everybody this week. Thanks a lot for coming again, and hopefully I'll have these problems all ironed out by next week. I'll be doing a ton of testing and experiments. So take care, everyone, and have yourself a good night. Bye-bye. Let's get this stream to stop. There we go. Okay, good night, everybody.